are falling. It's twilight time. Out of the mist your voice is calling. Tis twilight time. When purple colored curtains mark the end of day, I'll hear you, my dear, at twilight time. Deepening shadows gather splendor as day is done. Fingers of night will soon surrender the setting sun. I count the moments, darling, till you're here with me. Together, at last, at twilight time. Here, in the afterglow of day, we keep our rendezvous beneath the blue. In the sweet and same old way, I fall in love again as I did then. Deep in the dark, your kiss will thrill me like days of old, lighting the spark of love that fills me with dreams untold. Each day I pray for evening just to be with you. Together, at last, at twilight time. Here, in the afterglow of day, we keep our rendezvous beneath the blue. Hey, in the sweet and same old way, I fall in love again as I did then. Deep in the dark, your kiss will thrill me like days of old, lighting the spark of love that fills me with dreams untold. Each day I pray for evening just to be with you. Together, at last, at twilight time. Together, at last, at twilight
time. Hey there, you with the stars in your eyes. Love never made a fool of you. You used to be too wise. Hey there, you on that high-flying cloud. Though she won't throw a crumb to you, you think someday she'll come to you. Better forget her, her with her nose in the air. She has you dancing on a string. Break it and she won't care. Won't you take this advice? I hand you like a brother. Or are you not seeing things too clear? Are you too much in love to hear? Is it all going in one ear and out the other? Forget her, her with her nose in the air. She has you dancing on a string. Break it and she won't care. Won't you take this advice? I hand you like a brother. Oh, too much in love to hear. Is it all going in one ear and out the other?
Felt so wonderful, so very wonderful. Let's do it over again. Gina, Gina, I can't remember when I've ever felt a kiss that made me feel like this. Let's do it over. Such a lucky guy to have Gina, Gina, all for my very own. It's much too wonderful, so very wonderful, to know that Gina is mine
will be gone, and I'll have to move along. But till I do, I'll stay a while and track the hidden country of your smile. Someday the man I used to be will come along and call on me. And then because I'm just a man, you'll find my feet are made of sand. But till that time, I'll tell you lies and chart the hidden boundaries of your eyes. Someday the world I used to know will come along and bid me go. Then I'll be leaving you behind love is just a state of mind. But till that day, I'll be your man and love away your troubles if I can. But till that day, I'll be your man and love away your troubles if I can. In the world
request the Creator to illuminate your daily path. By placing the Divine at the center of your pursuits, asking for direction each morning, a miracle unfolds. Your existence transforms irrevocably. At this moment, the serene whisper of the Almighty assures you, seek first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and the universe will conspire in your favor. Proverbs 3. 5. 6 teaches us, trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge Him, and He will direct your paths. Therefore, the essential thing is not to know the route, but to trust in the one who holds the map. However, remember, this is not instantaneous. It does not appear spontaneously. It requires conscious effort and the full opening of your being to the divine light. Lewis, a living testimony to this truth, began his journey as a staunch atheist, but it was his insatiable curiosity and relentless quest for answers that led him to a profound spiritual journey. He discovered that by trusting in the Lord with all your heart, his life was transformed. Meaningful friendships, such as with J.R.R. Tolkien, challenged him to reconsider his beliefs. Through these conversations, he began to see the coherence and depth of Christianity. By opening his heart and mind to the possibility of God, Lewis experienced a radical transformation, reflected in his writings, that fervently defended Christianity. In his own words, I believe in Christianity as I believe that the sun has risen, not only because I see it, but because by it I see everything else. As Christ teaches us in Matthew 6:11, we must ask daily, give us this day our daily bread. Each new dawn is a blank canvas, an opportunity to align ourselves with the divine and ask, what is your purpose for me today, O Lord? Or what path should I take on this journey? It is like having a spiritual guide who always points us to true north, even when our eyes cannot see beyond the horizon. Lewis, with his wisdom, reminds us that God cannot give us happiness and peace apart from Himself, because it simply does not exist outside of Him. Recognizing our limitation in understanding the path, but fully trusting in divine wisdom, is the first step to opening doors we didn't know existed. Letting God guide our destiny is handing over the steering wheel of our life, assuming the role of co-pilot, with faith and surrender. We are not alone, we lean on the Lord, the architect of all paths. The verse from Jeremiah 29:11 resonates in my heart. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future. This promise is the foundation of our true peace and freedom, the assurance that every day God leads us to the best for our lives. Lewis urges us to reflect. If I find in myself desires which nothing in this world can satisfy, the only logical explanation is that I was made for another world. It is tempting to make our own plans and wait for divine approval, but this approach can lead us astray. It's like Noah attempting to build the ark without God's instructions. Surely it wouldn't float. Why not reverse this logic, Before any decision, big or small, seek God's guidance. If we feel the peace of the Holy Spirit proceed, if there is hesitation, perhaps it is a sign to pause and seek greater clarity. Let us recall the moment when Abraham was called to leave his home, as narrated in Genesis 12. 1. The scriptures report, "The Lord had said to Abram, 'Go from your country, your people, and your father's household to the land I will show you.'" Abraham did not have a map, but a serenity in his spirit. He fully trusted in the Lord's directions. Thus, it is essential that we seek the Lord every day. It's about maintaining constant communication. Reflect. Would you stay informed about current events with last week's news? Of course not. Similarly, our connection with God strengthens through daily, sometimes more frequent dialogues. It's about keeping this link always active. By seeking God regularly, we gain discernment. Life is full of choices. Some are trivial, but others can drastically change our destinies. Handling these choices can be overwhelming. However, by consulting God consistently, we gain insights that transcend our earthly understanding. He offers us a distinct vision, guiding our actions and ensuring we follow the path He designed for us. Daily challenges are overcome with new revelations from Him, directing us to decisions aligned with His purpose. Consistency in any relationship leads to intimacy. Friends, let me emphasize, consistency in any relationship leads to intimacy. The more we dedicate ourselves to God, the more we understand His nature, His love, and His desires for us. This bonding generates trust. As we become familiar with the Lord's heart, it becomes easier to hand over our concerns to Him. Our faith strengthens as we witness His promises being fulfilled day after day. A daily commitment to seeking Him ensures that our relationship with God solidifies, remaining firm even in life's adversities. Let's recall the story of Abraham, who, upon hearing God's call, left his homeland without hesitation, as narrated in Genesis 12. 1. He didn't have a map, but an unshakable trust that guided him. Abraham knew that even without seeing the way, the Lord's directions were sufficient. In mere Christianity, he teaches us that faith is the art of holding on to things your reason has once accepted, in spite of your changing moods. Therefore, it is vital to seek the Lord daily, maintaining constant communication with Him. Just as we don't update ourselves with old news, our connection with God requires frequent and current dialogues, keeping the link with the divine alive. If Christianity is false, it is of no importance. If it is true, it is of infinite importance. The only thing it cannot be is moderately important. By turning to God regularly, we gain discernment to face life's choices. Some decisions may seem trivial, but others have the power to change our destiny. With God as our counselor, we receive insights that go beyond human understanding, guiding us and ensuring we follow the path He planned for us. Consistency in any relationship leads to intimacy. The more time we dedicate to God, the more we understand His character, His love, and His desires for us. This bond generates trust, and by knowing the Lord's heart, it becomes easier to hand over our worries to Him. Our faith strengthens as we witness His promises coming true day after day. A daily commitment to God solidifies our relationship with Him, keeping it firm even in adversity. True goodness, practiced by those who have faith in Christ, is done without expecting anything in return, but for the pleasure of answering the divine call. Sometimes we cling to past glories, believing that old formulas will be the key to today's challenges. We may comfort ourselves with the thought, "This is familiar. I've been through this before. But wise King Solomon, in Ecclesiastes 3:1, to everything there is a season and a time for every purpose under heaven. This incites us to renew our strategies and perspectives in an era of rapid change. Clinging to the past or living on autopilot can leave us behind. Fortunately, divine mercy is new every morning, as Lamentations 3:22, 23 comforts us. Because of the Lord's great love, we are not consumed, for his compassions never fail. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. We can't go back and start over, but we can start now and make a new ending. If you have persisted in the same plan for a long time, it might be time to revisit your guidelines. God may be ready to start something new in your life. Are you prepared for this? Paul encourages us in Philippians 4:13. I can do all things through him who strengthens me. Therefore, let us be open to transformation, renewed daily by the word of the Lord, and guided by the Holy Spirit. The essence of our journey is not defined by what we already know, but by the constant guidance of the one who knows the best way. Lewis wrote, I believe in Christianity as I believe that the sun has risen, not only because I see it, but because by it I see everything else. As we navigate the uncertainties of life, let us remember that we have the supreme guide. Let us seek his direction. His heavenly guidance awaits us. It is essential to seek God's direction every day. Speak to God first. He says, consider the episode of the Israelites and the golden calf in Exodus 32:1-4. When Moses delayed descending from the mountain, the people, impatient, acted on their own, resulting in poor choices. In moments of uncertainty, the path is not always to move forward. Sometimes it is necessary to stop, reflect, and seek divine wisdom. Proverbs 3:5-6 advises us, trust in the Lord with all your heart, and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways submit to him, and he will make your path straight. Instead of reacting impulsively, why not take a moment for heavenly consultation? Lewis reminds us, prayer doesn't change God, but it changes the one who prays. Following God's direction can save us from unnecessary conflicts and hasty choices that we might later regret. Reflecting on David's life, a man after God's own heart, we see that even after defeating Goliath and facing numerous challenges, he never assumed he had all the answers. Before each battle or important decision, David sought the Lord's guidance. He knew that despite being an experienced warrior, God's perspective was infinitely broader than any human experience. In our own journey, we may feel tempted to rely on our past experience, but like David, we must remember that each situation is unique. Seeking God's direction ensures that our actions align with his plans, not just our assumptions. What God does for us, he does in us. Recognizing that God works within us in mysterious ways is an invitation to trust in his transformative work. The story of Joshua and the Gibeonites shows us the consequences of not seeking divine wisdom. Appearances can be deceiving, and without God's guidance, we can be seduced by empty promises. Humility is not thinking less of yourself, but thinking of yourself less. It is essential to seek divine direction, to discern the right path amidst life's distractions. I recall a funny story where two ladies mistook a rodent for a chihuahua. At first glance, it seemed harmless, but a closer inspection revealed the truth. Similarly, we must verify the authenticity of situations before accepting them into our lives. A conversation with God can save us from many problems. As we navigate the vast terrain of life, It is crucial to seek God tirelessly, not only in big decisions, but also in small ones. Lewis tells us that prayer doesn't change God. It changes the one who prays. Whether in business management, starting a relationship, or facing a family challenge, we need divine wisdom. Today I invite you to seek new direction and daily contact with the divine. As we do this, I have faith that God will guide our steps, protect us from pitfalls, and lead us to a future blessed by His grace. With humility and hope, I invoke divine discernment for every decision I will make. May the wisdom from above guide each choice, and may the Lord's presence be the beacon that illuminates my life. In the name of Jesus, I reject all confusion, hesitation, and doubt that may obscure my vision. Deliver me, Lord, from distractions and falsehoods that seek to lead me astray. I cry out for security and clarity, trusting that you are guiding my steps. I ask, Lord, for complete healing of my body, mind, and spirit, and that the peace that surpasses all understanding be my fortress. Protect me and my loved ones, declaring that all circumstances work in our favor. May your blessing accompany us, may your protection surround us, and may we be shielded from all evil. I implore your generosity in my life, that new horizons may open before me, filled with your grace and contentment. At this moment I join in prayer with all who hear these words. May we feel the warmth of your embrace, the firmness of your leadership, and the joy of walking with you every day. Guide us, Father, so that we do not rely solely on our own wisdom, but seek your direction in all we do. May your hand be upon us, leading us daily according to your perfect plan. In the name of Jesus, I proclaim that the love, grace, mercies, blessings, and prosperity of God fill our lives today. I am grateful, Lord, for hearing my prayers. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen. If these words touched your heart, respond with an amen in the comments. May the blessings of this prayer rest upon you. Share this message with someone who needs these words and support with a gesture of kindness. Subscribe to receive more messages that will warm your heart and elevate your spirit. We thank all who walk with us. You are blessed to be a blessing. Leave your prayer request in the comments, and together we will lift each one to God, seeking His blessings and victory. We invite the faith community to join in prayer for you. Even if you don't see an immediate answer, know that your prayers have been heard. We are interceding for each request according to God's will. We believe in the power of prayer to bring comfort, healing, and direction according to the divine plan. Stay firm in faith as we pray. To God be all the glory. May the grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all.